Jared Berenstein opened for me in Fort Collins, Colorado.
I still have to worry about telling that joke, like what if there's some Trump supporters in the audience? I mean, they're mostly
been to
joke.
A gas station.
I'm sorry, what?
You haven't been to a gas station.
I have been to a place where you're supposed to shut the fuck up when people tell jokes. Wait, what the fuck does that even mean? I don't even know where it was in my joke where you haven't been to a gas station works as a response.
You're excited about Biden.
Being elected.
Right.
Okay.
He thinks that Biden...
Oh, no, I don't need two people. Thank you very much. So you think that the people at gas stations are not excited about Biden? Is that what you're saying?
I'm saying anybody buying gas should not be excited.
I mean, people buying gas shouldn't be excited because we're contributing to global warming, which is going to kill us. But it doesn't matter, regardless, keep your fucking mouth shut, you know? Yeah, anyways, it doesn't matter. Okay, well, there's at least one Trump supporter in the audience. Which is funny, because I'm mostly in jail right now, so. Either in jail or in the hospital on ventilators. I mean to call you out. I think we can all agree, whether you were a Trump supporter or a good person, I think we can all agree.
So, during my set...
I was in Australia during the bushfires. I didn't realize that was the punchline. I was in Australia when half of their country was burning to the ground. Hey, that's a good one. Didn't mention the Colorado fires. Okay, do you know the difference? No, hold on a second. I'm talking to this guy. Were you the same one that didn't know how gas prices work? That was a different guy? Okay, cool. Oh, you guys are all pointing to that guy. Oh, well, that makes sense. The guy confidently sitting in two seats. That makes sense. Just a heads up. The Colorado fires are bad. They didn't kill 500 million animals. Do you know what the Australian bushfires are? Yes? And you're comparing them to the Colorado fires in the way that, like... like, the Colorado fires are bad in, like, a stubbed toe kind of way as compared to the bush fires, which are in, like, an unvaccinated COVID patient kind of way. Just making sure we're on the same page. Okay.
I'm with you back here. I got you.
No, I need more than one, though. I still can't get over the idea that you think the president controls the gas prices. I was listening from there. Do you think that's... Do you think it's not supply and demand? You think it's Biden artificially inflating the gas prices?
Absolutely impact.
Absolutely impact. Do you know that...
The pipeline shut down, gas prices...
Wait, hold on. No, guys, let him finish. Okay, so why were they this high in 2018?
I like that.
4 years ago, that was three. That's easy math. The United States president does not control the price of a barrel of oil in the Middle East.
Definitely impacted.
Okay, do you know how much of our oil comes from the Middle East?
So under Trump.
No.
Not the time or place.
And why did, hold on, sir, then why did you bring it up before? It's very weird, because I asked a question. Hold on, guys. I can, it's okay. I can handle Congressman Gates. If you knew how much came from the Middle East is because you seem to know a great deal about oil and the price of oil. And so I was just curious how much you knew, because it's 3%.
I can tell you that previously we had a surplus of oil and gas.
We had a surplus of oil and gas. Yeah, because none of us could drive because there was a pandemic.
We shut down,
I understand that you didn't think there was a pandemic, but the rest of us did. I just wanted to see whether or not it was a thing, it was like a miseducation thing.
It is, yeah.
Yeah, I was just curious. Okay. And I apologize that Jarrett earlier brought up the price of oil, which he did not. Because this is not the time or place to have that conversation, so. You know, here's the thing. I was coming to do a show in Fort Collins, and I'd never been here before. And people were like, hey, you gotta watch out, Steve. Fort Collins is Colorado, but it ain't Denver. It's two different things. And I was like, whatever do you mean? And they were like, well, see, Fort Collins is Colorado's Orange County. And I was like, whoa, I get it. What that means is that there are a lot of awesome people, and there are a lot of cool restaurants and shops, things like that, and there are also people that think the president controls the price of gas. Which, if that's true, considering it was at a low under Obama, hey, good work, buddy. Okay, we're gonna go back to the set now.
It was as high as two.
I thought it was just at its highest now. What happened to now?
It's not at its highest now, but it was at its highest under Obama.
Sir, what do you do for a living aside from not being able to read a room? You work in finance?
Yes.
Okay. What's great is you actually didn't even have to tell me that. I was pretty sure. What do you do in finance, sir?
Mortgages.
Okay, mortgages. What aspect of mortgages? Like the predatory lending part, or the... Which aspect?
That was 10 years ago.
Oh, yeah, no, nothing's predatory anymore. It's all fixed. Perfect, right? It's all fixed. Well, good, because Biden's president, so he must have done that. I'll move on. I mean, it's fun, but I'll move on. Because here's the thing, I came into a specific set, and I did that at the early show, and then I saw that happen during Jarrett's set, and I was like, I'm hungry for blood. All right, I'll move on. I gotta hurry up, gas prices are going up tomorrow. Okay, so I was talking about the Bush fires. Not President Bush, different Bush, sir.
You can do it!
No, I know, I'm just deciding if I want to. So I was the Bush fires in Australia, which was terrifying. Half that country was burning to the ground.
And then, during the Q&A.
So, aside from affecting gas prices, what's your favorite stop in Colorado?
What's my favorite Biden supermarket? I think flight.
Flight?
Yeah, flight.
Not for everybody.
It was, I like how he's a senile old man with dementia and also a maniacal genius at the same time.
Yeah. I think my favorite thing about him is that he's super lazy but also does too much. I think that's my favorite.
Later. Everyone just needs to stop talking about the gas prices, guys. Stop bringing it up. Everyone's like, ooh, what's gonna happen? I've never been to a show before. Is this where I state my misinformed opinions?
Thank you for watching and following and subscribing on YouTube, TikTok, Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram. If you want to see a live show, I'm probably performing near you soon. Check out my calendar and get tickets at stevehofstetter.com. And of course, join my Patreon where you can see videos like this before anyone else. Patreon.com/stevehofstetter.